Hi everyone, Brian Feenie here from measureQuick. I just wanted to share a really cool test you could do this season when you're in the home doing maintenance or service visits, whether you're in heating season or cooling season. It's called a static pressure screening. Now, that is in the quick test section of measureQuick. Click on quick tests on the home screen. You'll find static pressure screening. Once you select static pressure screening, it's going to bring up what you'll see here. And you'll be seeing it here on the screen in a minute. Now, first thing we need to do is set up our test. So when we set up our test, we're going to select our system type. So wait behind me here, I've got a gas furnace with an AC. So that's a split furnace system. Filter location again. When I look at the filter location here, I can see that I've got filter slot. So I'm going to select that in the workflow as well. And my rated static for the system, typically 0.5, but if you're seeing higher, obviously you could put that in there as well. Next thing you're going to see is a static pressure budget. So in an ideal system, you're going to find, based on that rated static of 0.5 in this example, return pressure, filter pressure, coil pressure drop, and supply pressure drop. And that's designed to help you understand, like, ideally where you should be, right? Now, one thing I do want to point out, if you are in heating season, this would be a good time to pull the disconnect on the outdoor unit, put the thermostat into a cooling call so we can run it full fan speed, right? Because that's really what we need to be able to assess when we're testing the system is what is happening during full fan speed. So next thing you'll see on the next screen to make measurements is where we're going to activate our Bluetooth probe to take our testing. So you can see right here, I'm using the new JB manometers. They just came out recently, on-screen display so that you can actually see your pressure readings on the device. But a quick tap of the button here and I can zero that out. And now go to my diagram and take my first reading in the return duct. So I'm going to quickly do that. I already zeroed it out. I've got my reading here coming in. And now I'm going to capture that. Now I'm going to measure after the filter. So I'm going to take that out. I'm going to go through this grommet here, but I'm going to first zero it out again. I'm going to get the reading there. I'm going to capture that. Next reading I'm going to take is between the heat exchanger and the coil. So some of you get a little nervous on taking or drilling that location. So this happens to have an area with a little slot in there. You can also drill on the side of the furnace between the coil and the heat exchanger. So I'm going to get this probe zeroed out. And now I'm going to put it in place. But I'm going to capture that as well. And now I'm going to take my supply reading. Which is up top here. So I'm going to take zero that out. One last capture for my supply reading. Capture that. Then I'm going to hit continue in the app. So I'm going to get my results at this point. So when I do that, it's passing with recommendations. So what does that mean exactly? I'm going to hit continue next, and I'm going to generate my report so I can take a deeper look at it, but also prepare myself to talk to the homeowner. So communicating to the homeowner is a very difficult thing to do when we're talking about duct systems and static pressure, because it's a complicated thing to explain. And probably in the past, no one has ever talked to that customer about static pressure. So you're going to go through your report. We see that it's passing with recommendations. Our total static here is 0.5, so we're right on the money. But we are seeing a high pressure drop on the return duct, likely because we've got a very tight system here. And then on the supply side, since we're a training unit up here, we've got a lot going on. So I'm going to go through, and this is going to provide me the resources to talk to the customer and identify the things that need attention, such as the return duct and the supply duct in this particular example. So the app's very helpful there. And it's also very helpful when you look at how we explain each category to the customer. It's in terms that they understand, right? We're not trying to talk to them with a ductulator and talk in inches of water column and decimal points. Like, that stuff can be very confusing, especially if the homeowner's never heard it before. So we've got the score. There's a place in the report where you can have your company logo, so it looks really professional, and you can help provide that information to your customer and give them a great experience, and also look at increasing your revenue for that particular project, right? If you're a comfort advisor in your company, this is even more important to be able to do this test when you're providing an estimate to the customer. So for comfort advisors, installing a couple diagnostic ports, investing in one manometer, you can tell a lot about a system before you sell it, so that your installation crew isn't having to deal with navigating a system with high static pressure after the customer just spent a lot of money to install a new system, right? This is a great test for comfort advisors, maintenance technicians, service technicians. This will really bail you out of some trouble here just by taking this real easy 3 to 5 minute test to do, and you get a great report from it. If you have any other questions, give us a call. We're here to help you.